I don't think I really need to change. What happened was just a problem of the way I played the years before, of not having summers off. So I really don't think that I'm going to have to change completely the way I play. Of course, I'm going to be a little probably more cautious, try to take more mid-range shots than getting fouled every time. But I think that's going to be enough.
So you won't hesitate then going to the basket like you normally would?
I don't think so. I got to be there to tell you. But I think when it counts and when I see the opportunity, I think I'll be the same.
How do you feel about all the acquisitions this summer?
Hard not to feel great. I mean, we are all very, very happy with the way Pop, RC, Peter Holt, and everybody did this summer. Four great additions, especially, of course, Richard Jefferson, Mike Dice, Theo Radcliffe, well, even Duane Blair or lately Keith Bowen, so it's more than four. We have a great squad, very, very deep, and we got all the spots covered, so we all very, very happy and ready to start.
It's kind of strange though to go in there into the locker room and not see Bruce, not see Fab, not even Kurt.
But Jock Vaughn, I mean, it's been 3 years, Fabry four, Bruce ever, always. Yeah. I mean, since I got here, he was always there, so he's a different locker room, but you know what you're gonna face when you choose this this job, so it happens. And we are lucky enough in this team to be able to play with some guys for a long time, get to know them, build friendships, so that's really good. And what we share with Bruce, with Fab, or with Jock is not gonna end just because we're not playing together anymore.
Along those lines, though, do you feel that a roster makeover was essential to keep this team competitive?
Depends. To keep it competitive, no. We were competitive, we've always been, and we were going to be with the same team. We finished second in the West with all the injuries, with the old guys that you were all talking about. So I think we were competitive. If we were ready to win the championship, that was a little harder. So to win it, we really need to add some players to the roster, and I think we've done it.
Going back to last year one more time, you know, it was two playoffs in a row you weren't healthy. Mm-hmm. Was it hard not to feel like you let the team down, even though it wasn't your fault? I mean, it was just an injury, but it was hard to sit there and...
The feeling was totally different from last year to the one before. At least I was there. I felt frustrated because I couldn't play as I wanted. We lost, but I was there. I felt guilty. I was there with them. Last year it was tougher, because I felt just like I was not part of the team. Like I was from the outside, even though, you know, what my teammates can say, coaches and everything, I was with a jacket and a dressing shirt. So not being able to lose with them, to win with them, to share the same emotions that you do when you have this one on, it was tough, and I really suffered it. It was depressing. I mean, for a bit. I mean, I'm not going to tell you that I was depressed the whole year, but at a point it was kind of depressing and frustrating.
When it comes to Tim, do you feel that maybe not a whole lot of time left to capitalize on him and take him, have you guys go to another championship with him leading the way?
I mean, we are at 32, 33, 34, the age we have. You're never going to be like when you were 25, and that's natural, and everybody goes through that. I think Tim has had a tough season last year because of injuries too. He was ailing from those knees the whole season, and I think he's going to be healthier in this one. He still is going to be an all-star. He can give us 20 and 10, and if it's not 20 and 10, it's going to be 19 and 9.5. So he's going to be going to give us a lot. But the fact that now we have, well, Tony being probably now the natural leading scorer of the team, hopefully Richard Jefferson and a healthy me, I think it's not going to be needed for Tim to score 25 and 15 every game. So it's going to be huge for us to have him healthy, first of all.
Is that just a big shift for this team in general? I mean, you just said that, you know, Tony is now the natural leading scorer. That just seems...
I think
a big step for this team. It's always been kind of him.
Yeah, but it's been happening. Last year he was, and it's not that we force him into, or like we had a, like a big meeting and saying, okay, now you gotta, you know, it just happens. And we all accept that he's 27, he's in his prime, of course, and he's playing great. He's becoming very reliable on that those mid-range shots, and it's been hard to stop for everybody. So we can all score here and there, but you know, Tony is probably our go-to guy now. So that's fine with all of us. And now with the addition of Richard Jefferson, that can, you know, last year he scored like 20 a game. So it's another weapon, and we needed one like that. So it's gonna be good.
Thanks,
got it. All right.